In this video, I'll be covering how to push emails into your Notion CRM so that you can tie them to contacts, as well as utilize AI to help you be a little bit more efficient. Then I'm going to walk you through setting up Zapier. And then after the emails are in Notion, I'm going to show you the AI possibilities. To get started, you'll want to make sure that you have a contacts database where you're able to store contacts' names as well as their email. You'll also want an emails database where you can store the subject, the email content, the date and time it was received, as well as tie it to a contact. You'll also want to create a new template for emails that is going to allow you, whenever an email comes into your Notion CRM, to be able to utilize the AI functionality here in Notion. So I've created one for being able to quickly generate a response, one to generate a summary, and also one to be able to get action items from whatever email has come into our CRM. That's it for the setup on the Notion side of things. Now let's create an email to utilize for testing. So for this example, I'm just going to go ahead and send an email to myself. I'm just going to give it a subject. Let's say this is a test for email push into Notion. And then for this test, let's go ahead and make it something that the AI is going to be able to respond back to. So I'm going to say, hey, Ben, I'm interested in your services as a Notion consultant. Can you please let me know how you can assist my business? That should be a good email for the AI to be able to respond back to as if it's a real life scenario. I've gone ahead and sent myself the email. And so what you're going to want to do after that is make sure that you star the email too. And when we're setting up Zapier, you're going to see why that is important. Now let's go over to Zapier. So now we're in Zapier, and the first thing that you'll want to do is go ahead and set up a trigger with whatever email provider you're using. For my case, I'm using Gmail. And what I have done is I have chosen the event to be whenever there is a new starred email. The reason why I wanted to do starred email is because if we were to do something like every new email, I get a lot of emails and I don't want a bunch of contacts and emails going into my Notion CRM that I don't really care about. So by choosing new starred email, it gives me the option to be a little bit more selective in what data is going to be flowing into Notion. But you could also select new labeled email if that's something that you prefer to be like a little bit more selective. After you've chosen the event, you're going to select continue, and then you're going to connect to your Gmail account. I've already done that. Then what you're going to want to do is go ahead and find an email within your email provider that you can use for the test through the setup process. So we're going to be utilizing this email that I just starred. So I'm going to select here and I'm going to load more. So I pulled this one a little bit ago and I'm going to choose this one that has just been starred 2 seconds ago. And you can see it has all of our information that I just sent myself. Then you're going to select continue. And then the next step is to find a database item in Notion. And what we're going to be doing here is we are going to be connecting your Notion account here. Then when you're setting up your Notion account, you're going to want to make sure that you're giving Zapier access to particular parts of Notion that contain contacts and emails and other information that are going to be utilized in this automation. If you've already connected Zapier, what you can do is go to your My Connections. And if you hit these three circles here, you're going to be able to reselect whatever you want to give Zapier access to. After you've connected your account, what you're going to do is search for your contacts database. Then you're going to go ahead and start entering some of the information from the email that you found here in the start email. So what we're going to do is you're going to come in here and this is name. So this is the contact's name. So I'm going to go and find the from name and select Benjamin Taylor. And you're going to do that for each one of these sections here. But the most important thing is making sure that you have name and email filled out. What we're doing here is searching your contacts database to see if the person that emailed you already exists within the database, because we don't want to create a duplicate contact. If Zapier doesn't find an existing contact in your Notion, then what we're going to do is create a Notion database item if it doesn't exist already. And this is where you're going to enter in some of the information. So you can enter your status, you could enter a lead source as well. And those are the two main things. And then you're going to select continue. And then here you have the option to test and actually send the contact to the database. So we're gonna give that a shot. We're going to select retest action. For you, most likely it will be just test action. And then let's go check in Notion to see if a new contact was created. We can see that a new contact was created, Benjamin Taylor, and then we have the email, so we're off to a good start. The next step is to create the email within Notion in your email database. So similar to contacts, we're going to create a database item. Your Notion account should already be connected at this point, so it should be pretty simple here. And then for database, you're going to choose emails. Then you're going to enter the subject into the subject field that you created. And then as well as you're going to enter body plane into email content. Then for include time and date fields, we're going to select true. Then for the start date and time, we're going to put in the date received from Gmail so that we can tell on the Notion side whenever we got this email. Then you're going to select continue and let's test and push this email into Notion. So we're in Notion and the email was successfully pulled over. We have the subject, we have the email content, and we have the date time received. And let's go ahead and select open. And if you created your email template here, let's go ahead and select this email template that you might have created. And then you have your AI information here. Let's go ahead and copy to the clipboard, throw it into the body. And then for whichever one you want to do, let's go ahead and create an AI response, hit generate. You can see it's created a response there. We could also do the summary. Or for longer emails, you can generate action items. Say we want to go ahead with the AI response, you could just copy and paste this, go back into your Gmail, and simply just hit paste. Then you have a nice and quick response to the people that you're emailing with. If you're happy with how everything worked out in the automation, all you have to do is hit publish on the Zapier side of things. And then whenever you start emails, or whatever the trigger is you set up here in the starting section, that is going to fire and you're going to be able to get your emails within Notion. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video covering Notion.